Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home. Settle down, it'll all be clear. Don't pay no mind to the demons, they fill you with fear. The trouble in my drag you down.
Morocco is really different compared to the U.S. Especially, I have been experiencing both kind of homestay. While I was in the U.S., I was pretty boring every day, except that there were a little amount of homework that I needed to do. Well, I didn't expect that it was not boring in Morocco at all, because of my host mom is working in the Arsenal Center, so I had to go to work with her every day, except the group time, lunch, dinner, and bedtime. I helped in the Arsenal Center, met different people even though they couldn't speak English well. We used our hand to communicate. I had a lot of fun working with them.
My favorite part of Morocco was by far the homestay experience. I was with a family of four and a daughter about my age, which made it a lot more exciting. Most of the days I spent at home with my homestay mom, just either cleaning or cooking while the daughter was at school. I also spent a lot of time with them exploring the markets and meeting some of the daughter's friends. Morocco will be an experience I will never forget, and I miss my family so much.
My favorite part about the trip to Morocco was the homestay. My family was really nice, and I had an older sister and two younger sisters. And my mom was a stay-at-home mom, and my dad was a taxi driver. They were all really nice to me. Even though the communication was a little challenging sometimes because I could only speak in French or the tiny bit of Arabic that we learned. And the food that they cooked was always really good, even though they overstuffed me like all the time.
My favorite part about our trip to Morocco was visiting Fez. I thought it was really cool how we had a lot of free time to just go and walk around in the Medina. And we also had a scavenger hunt, and I thought that was the best way to just get familiar with the Medina. So on later trips through the Medina, we would have a sense of where we wanted to go and what we wanted to buy and from certain shops.
The most interesting thing in this trip for me is to talk with my host family. The life in Morocco was different than the life in America or in China because their language system is totally different than ours. My host family only speak and understand a little bit of English, and I also only speak a tiny little bit of Arabic. However, we could still communicate successfully by speaking words with gestures. The things I didn't expect was also talking with my host family. I didn't expect that we could chat for a few hours after dinner and we could understand each other. The experience was so impressive.
I loved the whole trip to Morocco, but if I had to pick a favorite place, it would either have to be Fez or Chefchaouen. These are my two favorite places because we had a lot of freedom as a group and as individuals. In Fez, we were able to walk around the Medina a lot and shop and do a scavenger hunt. In Chefchaouen, we were able to do projects like the photo assignment that Kristen assigned. It was nice for us to go out and use our ability to communicate with the people even though there was a language barrier. Another plus about these places is that they were really pretty. All of Morocco was beautiful, but at the top of the hike to the Spanish mosque was the best thing I've ever seen.
Part of Morocco was probably walking the streets of Fez because it was really fun to see all the different shops, like walking down these narrow alleys with all these trinkets. And it was also fun to like negotiate the prices because that's something you can't do in America. And a lot of the shops were outdoors because we were in a narrow alley, and very rarely do you see an indoor shop.
Hello. Me personally, I don't have a personal favorite moment of the trip just because this was a totally new experience for me, but I just really enjoyed experiencing a new place and culture and seeing how different people in the world go about their daily lives.
My favorite part about our trip to Morocco was going around the country and seeing the different cities. This gave me a wide variety of perspectives on how people go about their daily lives and what a daily life looks like. The thing that was most interesting to me was learning about the country and its people. Since most of Morocco is predominantly Muslim, it has a large effect on their daily lives, and learning about that was really fascinating to me. Morocco is very different from the US for those reasons, but another thing that stuck out to me was the food. You could tell that the food was cooked and grown locally, as well as not much shipping was done. Food was also eaten at a very later time. I didn't really know why, but in the end I adjusted to it, and it was fun. Something that really stood out to me that I wasn't really expecting was eating the food. I was a little wary going into the situation because I had never eaten food like that before. But in the end, after trying it, I realized it was actually good and I should keep more of an open mind.
I'm very used to seeing very carpeted forestry all around me, with the exception of going out west. So pretty much the only two really biomes I've experienced through before this was high desert and forest. So it was kind of nice seeing something that you could say was a hybrid of the two. It was definitely unique in its own way. Chefchaouen was definitely the most interesting part of the trip for me, just because it was the first city that I felt impressed by, and it was, in my opinion, the most aesthetically pleasing city. I guess you could say that it's the most prettiest. The most different thing was the house sizes. You see, in my home stays, the size of my house was smaller than what I was used to. I actually asked about it. I was like, is it smaller so that you can fit more people into one building? And their answer is no, it's got everything we need, so I don't need any more. So that was definitely interesting, because the houses I'm used to, you have plenty of excess space. Like, you have your living room, your dining room, kitchen, and there'd be a room off to the side, like a reading room. So it was unique to see something that wasn't. The central room had the dining room, the living room, all of that. Something that was unexpected for me was food poisoning.
Something I didn't expect on the trip was to get as close with our trip leaders in Morocco as we did, not just Mr. Penley and Madame, but we also had two other trip leaders, Kristen and Shuaib, and they also became mentors for us. And I think that they made the trip a lot better, and the trip wouldn't have been the same without them.